Hi, I'm Dave Phillips. I'm here at the Titleist Performance Institute, and today I'm going to share with you the one thing that the best players in the world do that maybe you don't, and it's called SPACE. So let me explain. SPACE is actually an acronym for speed, power, accuracy, consistency, and efficiency. And here's the deal. The best players in the world create space not only on the backswing, but on the downswing. Let me explain. So when you set up to a golf ball, you generally hinge from your hips and you have a degree of space between the handle of the club and your body. What the best players do is on the backswing, they load into their trail hip. They create space. As the club moves to the top of the backswing and they start their downswing, notice their lower body starts to work down and back, and then it works underneath them and up. They are always creating space. So if I grab a golf club and demonstrate for you here, if I take a setup position, here's my space. On the backswing, I go to the top of the backswing. As I start down, my lower body, specifically my belt, starts to separate. It works behind me as my handle comes down. I start to push against the ground with my legs and I create even more space. This is the secret to great golf ball striking. If you can create space, you can retain your wrist angles. You can create pressure and force on the shaft and create speed and power. Now, we've been doing research here at TPI for a long time on the best players in the world. And this truly is the one thing that distinguishes the best from everybody else. So here's a few other ways to think about it. I'm gonna take this alignment rod. I'm gonna put it through my two front belt loops. And here's a great thing for you to do at home. You can take a alignment rod or an old club shaft, put it through the two front belt loops like so. At address, I'm gonna hinge forward and I've got this bar to guide you. On the backswing, I want you to load into your glute. So I want you to take this front belt loop and put it where your back one is. You're gonna turn your hips. I've created space for the club to move up to the top of the backswing. Now watch what my hips do. On the downswing, I simply put my lead side back to where it came from. That makes my belt buckle work back underneath me. And now when I push against the ground, I'm clear. I've got plenty of room for my arms and the club in it to enable me to compress the golf ball and create that space. From the face on view, it looks like this. I set up, I load into this hip. In transition, I want you to put your lead side back first. Don't fire your hips immediately. That's dangerous. If you fire your hips immediately, a lot of times it creates side bend. The club can get trapped behind me. If you're one of those players that hits a block to the right for a right-handed golfer, or you block it and then hook it, that could be because your hips are spinning out and your upper body can't catch up. So you want to have this feeling of good turn on the backswing. On the downswing, I want you to separate. You'll sometimes hear of this as a Sam Snead squat or a little squatting mechanism. I go to the top of my backswing. I separate my lead side, which pushes my hip back underneath me. That allows my arms to drop down in front of me. And now I push with my lead leg. My arms are already clear of my body. I've created space. So remember, if you want to have speed, power, accuracy, consistency in your golf swing, and efficiency, you've got to create space.